Hey everybody, I'm Timmac, and this is going to be a video on Star Citizen, the basic controls and moving around and all the stuff to get into the game for your first time. I've been streaming Star Citizen for a couple years. I've been enjoying the content over there, so I thought I would give YouTube a little bit of love over here and show you some stuff. If you like it, make sure you put some comments and like the video, but let's get right on into it. Let's get into the universe. This is your main screen. When you first load in, you'll have Universe, Star Marine, Arena Commander. Star Marine's an FPS action type of shooter. Arena Commander, a little more flying and racing in a smaller environment. You get your friends list over here. And notifications, when you get friend additions or you crash out, you may be able to rejoin into your last session as well as party invites. But if you're a new user, my experience is going to be a little bit different. Normally, you'll hit Universe. You'll have a bunch of different areas you can end up spawning in. You'll have like Area 18, Microtech, Loreville. I'm not exactly sure the how they go about it, but you have different planets you can start on. For this, where I am located right now at my last logout, I was in Microtech, New Babbage. If you were to click Stand System now and visit location, you may already be going on in there. You'll most likely end up hitting your character customization screen next. So first you choose your gender. I've already got stuff picked out. You'll pick your gender. You cycle through different sources, your base character here. I like this haircut, so I'm gonna be using it. You pick that guy. You can start blending with different heads. So it's like, if I like the look of both of these guys, I could be like, yeah, I like his nose a little bit. We'll move that around a bit. You got the ears, you can wiggle them around, whatever you want to do. But that's good for now. You got hairstyles, eye color, tons of different stuff. And then you can just go review it. That's what I look like. Sexy. And we'll go right on in. Save your changes. Go right in the Santon system and visit the location. We'll start loading in here. If you're new and you haven't bought into the game, I just wanted to let you know we do have a referral link. You start out with 5,000 credits if you were to just sign up on your own. If you use my referral link, you'll have an additional 5,000 credits to pretty much use on like basic things like weapons and armor. Just stuff to get you kind of going in the beginning. But it is very helpful if you don't have the extra cash in the beginning, so it's a good starter fund. Make sure you use my link and sign up there using that. But let's get into the game and show you how to do some stuff. All right, well, we're in. So I just hit A to get out of my bed. It's a long night of sleep. You can also, if you were in this bed, there's a key for inner thought. Inner thought is the way you interact with the world around you. So WASD and D will get you to move around. Your mouse will look around. Holding F will give you your inner thought. It allows you to do things like sit down. So if I want to sit down on the seat, you hold F and click. If you hit F by itself, it'll usually default to the main action as well. Hitting Y will get you out of your seat. So if I wanted to just hit F, that'll also do it instead of having to click on it. So basic actions on F will be very nice and useful for your inner thought. We're going to leave our habitation here. So you already know how to walk around. If you want to slow your walk speed down, you just scroll wheel down to a very slow walk. Or you can scroll back up to go to full speed walk. And if you hold shift, you'll sprint. If you want to crouch, press control, X for prone. And then space will raise your stance. So you can hit that twice to go back to standing, and space again will jump. If you want to lean with a weapon, it's going to be Q and E. Voice over IP, you have two options. If you hold plus on the numpad, that'll talk to your party. If you want to talk to just proximity, you hold Alt and then press the numpad plus. So I'm holding F, clicking on that. We're calling the elevator. But while we're waiting, we'll get the elevator up here and I'll go through this thing called the mobiGlas. So we're going to hit F1 to pull up our mobiGlas and we'll go through all the different tabs. Right here, you can see your current balance. You can have your vehicle status down here, your mission status that you're tracking, your vitals. You know, what's your heart rate at? the atmosphere around you, if there's any oxygen, I guess this is nitrogen, carbon dioxide. Is that argon, I'd imagine? And the atmospheric pressure. You have your suit oxygen, seeing how much you have left. Oxygen, I think it doesn't matter because we have we are already in an oxygen-filled room or atmosphere or something like that. So you have oxygen tank, your EVA fuel that's flying around with your suit, and your power output. So let's go over the mobiGlas here. So your first tab is going to be your comm link. You can also access that by hitting F11. Hopefully there isn't anything too derogatory in the chat here. Well, it looks like we're good. But in here, you're going to see your channels. Over here, you'll see global chat. You can also see your party chat as well as your ship chat. Those are three different options you can have while looking through here. So if you wanted to talk to or just sort your logs through each section, you can do so. On the top right, you'll also have connect to audio channel, and that'll work for all three of them. So if you wanted to connect to the audio channel, you can then talk to everybody on the ship, everybody in your party, or if you just wanted to stay in global, you could just stay here and talk in proximity. It won't send to the whole server, but it will be at least nice to talk to the people around you using proximity. Under friends, you'll see all of your friends. However, a nice little caveat is going to be at the top, you'll see the spaceport when you're entering and leaving for landings. Don't worry too much about that right now. We'll be going over that in the ship flight tutorial. And then obviously pending requests, you'll see anything that's been sent to you in terms of party requests or friend invites. On your right here, you're going to have things, all your friends over here. So if you wanted to invite people, actually, this is going to be your global chat. If you were to be in your group or ship chat, you'll see all the members of those things coordinating to those different groups on the right. If you go to manage, you'll also see this connect to audio channel that's redundant to the same thing on the top. Send a visor chat if you want to remove it. If you don't want to see all of the general chat going from your, if you didn't want global chat to show up and you wanted the party or the ship chat to stay there, you can limit that. You can change the text color. You can also change your microphone volume and sound volume there. And that's pretty much it for the friends tab. You can also hit F2. That'll default if you, from your main screen, to go straight into the star map. You're like, I don't see anything. This is normal. Just double click right mouse button, and that'll bring you out to your star map, and you can look around. Right now, we are all the way over on this planet, way out in the outskirts of Stanton. To get into this system, you double click. You can look at just this. It'll show you the moons. Like, once again, you can right-click double time, go back out to Stanton. But if you want to drill down a little bit further on Microtech to see where we are, we just scroll wheel all the way up, and we are actually on New Babbage right now. This is our location. Next thing, Equipment Manager. This is where you have all your armor and clothing and all the sorts. So if I wanted to take this EVA suit off, this undersuit, we can take that off and look at me now. Oh yeah. So you could save the changes if I wanted to take that undersuit off and have all my clothes on and look at me now. I look beautiful. Yeah. Look at that. Oh yeah. All right, get back in there. Let's throw some armor on because we're going to be jumping into a spaceship and we don't want to get thrown out to if we blew up or ejected. I want to make sure I have some oxygen to call for a friend to get me back. So this is the armor settings here. We'll go back to like what you would start with here. So you normally would just click save changes and equip. The next tab is going to be your weapons. So you have a primary and a secondary weapon. So this one is just the base undersuit. You can hold one primary weapon and one sidearm. With different armor sets, you can have multiple weapons and extra magazine slots and utility slots and all of the sort. But once you throw that armor on, when you go to a store and buy it, you need to go into your armor tab. You can throw some stuff on. Like, I've got this cool, we'll go with the Arctic helmet. We'll throw on the MKX Core Arctic there. We'll do the MKV arms. I've got a mix and match set up here. This isn't always what I wear. And we got that looking great. We'll save that. And if you look back at your weapons area, you have many more different slots and utility items. Oh, we skipped one, the vehicle loadout manager. These are all your different ships. A lot of these that are locked will pretty much mean because they're in a different location. You can see all the different ships I have. I have quite a few. The 890 jump is beautiful. If we wanted to go look at that and, you know, scroll it around, look at our ships, just show it off. And then look at this. This has all of your different missile slots, propulsion systems, your quantum drive. This is a bad one because it's got capital ships. Let's pick something a little smaller to make it a little bit easier to read. So you'll have, like, for the, say, the Cutlass Black, you have the propulsion systems. You can change your quantum drive, your systems, your coolers. You have two coolers, a power plant, and a shield generator, weaponry, all your different missile racks. You have a gimbal mount with a laser repeater attached to it. Another gimbal mount with the Scorpion attached to it. And that's pretty much the gist of that. You can scroll through all the different options. I'm having a hard time scrolling. I don't know why. And then you have a paint setup, which is coming in 3.10. You'll be able to change all the different paint schemes and buy them. And it'll be a little bit nicer instead of having just a stock different, you know, default setup that you end up purchasing alone. Your journal here. All the different things you discover, and I think missions will go in here as well. I haven't really explored too much into the journal, but enjoy all the lore you can find in there. The LiveWorks AR, modify shipport equipment. I don't even know if this is active yet. I haven't even seen this yet. But not too important if you don't. Oh, I've never gone in there. It's not a big deal. When you land at a spaceport, you have your vehicle maintenance services where you can repair your ship, restock its weapons, refuel its hydrogen and quantum. After a long journey, you'll probably need to do that. And your last tab here, when you're picking up contracts, these are all your quests you can pick and choose from. So right now, you got courier assignments and all these different deliveries, investigations to normally explore different mines and find a dead dude in there. Bounty hunter missions to go track down different pirates or crime-statted individuals or online. You've got mercenaries removing claim jumpers and this call to arms thing. A civilian force needs you. You get a bunch of different credits for doing that. These are more combat-oriented. Personal. These you may have some things that'll pick you up some crime stat in here. So there's some sketchy stuff in here. You may want to dabble in that. But once you do pick a mission, they'll end up in your accepted contracts. You can track them from there. When you're done with them, they'll go in your history. And then you have this other one for beacons. So if you wanted to call for an escort, somebody can come accept that mission, come pick you up and or bring you somewhere if you were mining or something like that. I haven't done too much with escort missions. Personal transport, if you get stuck in space, you want to go. It's like, oh, well, I need you to pick me up. I need to go. I need to make it over to this mining area or something. Like, I don't know why you'd go there, but you can tell them how much you'll pay them for the journey and they can come and get you. That's that. And that is your Mobi. But now, we'll walk around, we'll go down to the spaceport, and take out our first ship. We'll scroll down and hit the lobby. Ah, the lobby. Also, F12 can get rid of the chat. We're gonna close that out to make things look nice. All right, that's going to wrap it up for the basic movement controls in mobiGlas. If you enjoyed this video, please click like and subscribe to the channel and leave any comments down below with any feedback. I know this is our first video, so all feedback is very welcomed. I hope you enjoyed it. And on the next video, we're going to be talking about basic flight and controls. So tune in for that. Thanks, guys.